Here's the moment you have all been waiting for. Welcome to CVCC Esports here on the campus at Catawba Valley Community College. Thank you so much for everybody who's tuning in. As you see the countdown counter there, we're a little bit behind, but we'll make sure we get our 24 hours in. Welcome to our 24-hour streamathon here for CVCC Esports. We appreciate everybody who's joining us for the stream here today. We are live from the campus of Catawba Valley Community College here at the Gaming Arena. We got a little bit better set up here, changed a little things, trying to get things ready and geared up for what is going to be an awesome 24 hours. Some really interesting things you're going to see. We're going to be playing games that we normally play, but we're going to be playing games that we don't normally play. We're going to get you set up, ready to go. Before we get going, we want to give a shout out to our sponsors for this entire school year. They've been so awesome. Both are going to be coming back on board with us for next calendar year, so we're very excited about that. But we want to thank Red Fox Gaming in Hickory and Catawba Valley Boulevard. This is the holiday season, so if you've got family members that want Christmas items, they want video games, they want all sorts of things. You see Crass here in the background. I'm trying to move my mic and get out of the way. Crass and Sky, who is new to our team for the next semester. Crass, who's on our team, they're going to be coming in and out all day, so it's going to be wild. They're actually going, I believe, now to get some Waffle House. Is that correct? Waffle House? Yeah, so we're already gearing up for this hike that we're getting ready to get into. But getting back to our sponsors, thanks to Red Fox Gaming, Hickory. Please go visit them for your holiday needs. They've got pop figurines. They've got new and old video games. They have everything pop culture that you want. They've got Pokemon cards. My brother wanted some for Christmas. I stopped by there and got some. So be sure to go visit them. Tell their owner, Spencer, and tell their employees, we appreciate the support that you're giving CVCC Esports and local students here in the Catawba Valley area. And also shout out to Corporate Armor, a Temprano Tech Vestors company. We appreciate Luke Walling and his group sponsoring our team here this season. They've helped us tremendously. Luke and his group at Corporate Armor recently just celebrated their largest third quarter in company history. So they're successful. They're helping us be successful here at CVCC. So aside from that, what we want to kind of let y'all know about. So today is our streamathon. So where are we going from noon today, which was just 3 minutes ago, and you see the countdown counter up here in the corner. We're going to be going from noon today until noon tomorrow. We're going to be streaming, playing, competing, doing all sorts of craziness. This was an idea that was started by a lot of our esports team members. They said, hey, coach, can we do this? I did not know originally if we were going to do this or not, but they talked me into it, and we're actually doing a fundraiser through the end of the month. It's tied in perfectly to help raise money for our esports team here at Catawba Valley. So I thought it was just a great way to be able to let them have the experience of doing this 24-hour subathon. We've seen a lot of streamers do it in the past, and it's been successful for them. Hopefully it'll be successful for us. We can raise some money for student athletes. If you want to donate, you see the link there in chat. You can do !donate. That is where you will donate your money to help this program. Right now we have a goal set for $10,000. If we get $10,000, I don't know what I'll do. I really don't. I don't expect that kind of money to come through. But if it does, if you know somebody with some deep pockets, if you know companies that want to donate money here at the end of the year for tax purposes, please send them over to us and our esports program. Also, our athletics program is running this same type of fundraiser overall to raise money for all of our programs. We have some wonderful programs here at CVCC: baseball, softball, men's and women's basketball, volleyball, and then our non-traditional sports, bass fishing, and of course esports. And we're actually adding cross country to the mix here in the coming school year, fall of 2022. So if you know somebody that likes to run and get an affordable education, they will have the chance to do so here at CVCC. So, but that'll be how you can help support us. You can also subscribe to us. We get money off of that. We would much rather you donate to the E-Team sponsor link, but we will take subscriptions, and we will also take any donations that you send through here as well. All of that is going to go to help student athletes. None of that comes to me. That comes to helping the student athletes that you'll be seeing here the next 24 hours. So please dig deep. If you've got $20, if you've got $10, $5, whatever it is, go to that link, !donate, and be sure to donate. Also, if you want to support us in other ways, obviously following our stream and being in stream, that'll be very, very awesome. You know, that any viewership that we get on our streams, that helps us grow and get, you know, the ability to do some really awesome stuff. Also, you can do exclamation point Twitter, exclamation point YT, and exclamation point Insta. That will allow you to follow our Twitter pages, our YouTube pages, and our Instagram page. And also, if you want to buy some merch, you see the cool merch here. Our friends over at Custom Design Group, you can do exclamation point merch. And you can buy a t-shirt, support us. I don't know if we get any kind of cut off of that. I believe we do. But if we don't, then you know, you're still supporting our team, wearing our gear, and you know, helping us do some awesome things for student athletes. They've been really, really awesome this fall. It's been a blessing for me personally, just sharing my own personal testimony on what this program's meant to me. You're going to hear some testimonies as well throughout the stream, so just be sure to, you know, come on and support us. So we're kind of counting down. I'm trying to kill some time right now as we're waiting for Dr. Garrett Henshaw, our president, is going to join us here live in the gaming arena for the first time, be streaming CVCC Esports and doing some, we're going to have him do some MLB The Show. I don't know if Dr. Henshaw has ever played a video game. I haven't ever had a chance to ask him. But, yeah, so we're, I believe our team is going to go get food. You good?
We're just testing how much of a delay that we have.
No, there's no delay.
No, there's definitely some delay.
Yeah. At least like a 3-second delay.
10 seconds.
Oh, interesting.
It's fine. It's fine.
All right, well, we got a little bit of a delay, but yeah, so we're, yeah, if you, and also other ways you can follow us or help us, follow us on here as well. There's a purple follow button in one of these corners here. Hit the follow button. Make sure you support our esports program. So it's going to be really, really awesome. We've got Parzival walking in right now. The man cake himself is getting ready to probably grace us with his presence on stream. You're going to see something really interesting with him later tomorrow morning. You're going to join us for breakfast with pancakes with the man cake. Of course, Bradley's character, Flapjack. He is, you see him? There he is. Also, awesome student. 20 credit hours and an A in every class. Holy crap. I wished I could do it as a student. I was decently intelligent, but that is awesome. And works a part-time job and competes in 2 game titles. So how cool is that? So, yeah, join us. You'll join us for 8 o'clock. Actually, let's give you kind of the lowdown. Here's kind of how the schedule is going to work. So you see the 24-hour stream, Thursday, December 16th. That is today from noon. We're going to do opening comments. Then we're going to have a little Dr. Garrett Henshaw here. It says 12:15. I think it's going to end up being about 12:30, just talking with him. Then from 1 to 3 p.m., we're going to be doing a Smash Brothers tournament. Your coach is going to be participating in this, as well as our student gamers who many of them are going to be participating in Smash Bros. Next semester. We've got a large roster of Smash Bros. Players, which I'm really excited about. Then from 3 to 4, we're going to play Mario Kart. From 4 to 6, we're going to be doing Fortnite squads. And a lot of these will just be random people. We'll just kind of see how it goes. From 6 to 7, we're going to be playing Call of Duty Zombies. That's going to be interesting. Call of Duty next semester, we're also going to try to field a team, so we're going to see how that goes. From 7 to 9, we're going to play really what was our feature game of the spring, which was Valorant. I am excited about this one. I believe we're going to have Crast, a.k.a. Jesus, Jesus, as either one. I haven't figured out quite which one he prefers, but I call him Jesus. A lot of people on the team call him Jesus. He's going to be streaming Valorant. And we're going to be playing from 7 to 9. Your coach is definitely going to be participating in that one. It's one of my new fun games. From 9 to 10, we're going to be playing Crab Game. So for you people who watch Netflix, the Squid Game show that was on, Crab Game is essentially the cartoon version of Squid Game. And so it's very interesting, but we're going to play that. Obviously, you have to be the last person to survive to win. From 10 to 11, we're going to be doing Oculus games for the first time on stream. Beat Saber. I don't know how this is going to go. We'll see. I've never done it before, but we're going to do Oculus games from 10 to 11. Then from 11 to midnight, we're going to play some Apex Legends. We've never played Apex on stream either, and so we're going to try that out. And at the behest of my players, from midnight until 2 a.m., we're going to play a game called Phasmophobia. I don't know if I spelled that right on the stream graphic I made, but Phasmophobia.
It looks about right.
Yeah, Parzival's joining me, by the way. You can't see him because we don't have the camera on right now. But we're going to be playing Phasmophobia. So for those of you that don't know what Phasmophobia is, basically we're going to be ghost hunting. And your coach is terrified of anything. I don't watch scary movies. My wife, bless her heart, she wants me to watch scary movies with her. And so I never really do that. So, we're going to be hunting ghosts for 2 hours. And so your coach is going to try to get through that and do well. And then from 2 to 8 a.m., community games, Among Us, Jackbox Party Pack. We may do some other games. But we're going to try to keep it PG, but keep it maybe open to the community. And we may try some other things. I don't know. We kind of left that time slot open because we know there's going to be a lot of you that may be asleep. We may have an Australian audience. I don't know. That's the time. So then from 8 to 9 a.m., you see it there, 8 to 9 a.m., Pancakes with the Man Cake. And that IRL is in real life. So in real life cooking stream, Bradley is going to make pancakes on stream. It's going to be awesome.
It's going to be great.
Yeah. And so for those of you who don't know Bradley is an aspiring, wants to open his own restaurant. He is actually going to be a part of our school's hospitality academy next semester. So really, really excited for him. But he's going to get a chance to cook on stream. And, you know, I thought about it. I was like, you should have brought your guitar. See, Bradley also is a talented artist. Actually, we have a couple of those. He plays guitar. We actually have Nick who plays Smash Bros. He plays drums.
For the jazz band.
Yeah.
The jazz ensemble.
Jazz ensemble here at CBCC. Yeah. So we've got a lot of talented people. We actually could have just done like a little, you know, jazzy, like, I don't know. But I don't think we're going to do that. We'll see. I don't know. We just don't know. And then how would you follow Pancakes with a Man Cake other than letting Bradley play as Flapjack on Fortnite? We got to. And we'll be doing that for a little bit. And then, obviously, we'll be closing it out 11:45 a.m. tomorrow. So about 23 hours and change until then. So really, really awesome. So I'm joined over here by Bradley. Let's bring Bradley in. I'll scoot out of the way as you see Brett. I'll have to keep it over there. Oh, here we go. So
we got Santa hat. We got it.
Yeah, we got Bradley as I might have to bring his down just a little bit. We got Bradley dressing up as got a little Santa hat. I forgot mine. I feel bad. So look at this. We're matching that.
My shirt's starting to get withered.
A little faded.
A new
yeah.
shirt. Yeah.
That's
it's well worn.
That's what happens when you're original. Like you have the gear for so long that you got to get new gear. So which we actually did get. Shout out to Custom Design Group. Got us our gear for the it's kind of the midway point of the season. So it's awesome. If you're in chat, say hello. Let us know how you are. We're probably about 15 minutes from Dr. Henshaw coming on. I just realized I need to tweet this out and send it out to our local platforms. Bradley, you want to say anything? You can kind of take it.
If anybody spoils No Way Home, we will be we will be blocking you from chat.
Yes.
Also,
exactly.
Don't spoil Survivor. I'm going to watch that tonight.
Oh, yeah, I haven't seen that either.
Yeah, please don't spoil that. We will block you. Please don't. Yeah. We don't want to block anybody.
Don't spoil Spider-Man. Don't spoil
Survivor. Yeah.
Hey, Damien!
Hey!
Oh, and Brownie Boy's in here, which actually he's in the room with us now. So.
Whoa.
Don't spoil anything. Xander Man, it's real life. It's a real life Santa Claus. Yeah. Are you still on a 3-minute delay? No, we are not on a... if you're on your phone, you may be on a little bit of a delay. But if you're on computer, I think it's like maybe a 2-second delay. It's not a delay at all. So, but yeah, we're streaming for the next 23 hours and 44 minutes.
Yes,
many of us are going to be streaming in here. It's going to be wild. How are you feeling heading into this whole thing?
I'm great. I got 30 more extra minutes of sleep than I normally do. So. We're good. We're not going to sleep. We're staying up. We're going to be playing games. We're going to have a great time. We're going to try to show some awareness for the esports program. I cannot talk. Sorry. The esports program. And it's going to be a great time. Cody over here, he's going to be playing horror games. That's going to be great to watch. Please come and watch that. It's going to be a fun time.
I don't know about that being fun for me, but we'll kind of see.
Don't worry. I don't like scary games either. I'm going to be right here beside you watching you play.
I know that there's going to be some content come out of this as coach is scared to death of the stuff happening and all these ghosts and craziness happening, and us putting down salt trying to find ghosts. That's wild. I don't know. It's gonna be crazy. So, but yep, I'm tweeting out right now. We're getting the live link to our stream.
You guys missed a heck of a stream last night. If you guys didn't tune in, we played Fortnite squads. We had all the Breakfast Club come in person, entire Breakfast Club, and we had a few of them play, and one of them didn't lose any of the six games that they played, and I was very surprised by that. This is their first time they ever played. That's kind of funny.
That's pretty wild.
Yeah.
And we've had some success on our live stream stuff for Fortnite. So, Xander in chat. He's one of our players for Smash Bros. He's actually graduating this semester. I'm going to see Spider-Man tonight before I come join the stream, but don't worry, I won't spoil. Yeah, you better not. No Spider-Man spoilers.
We will lock you out of the arena.
For those of us that could not get tickets and get in, and but yeah, so we're getting this started. I'm tweeting out the stream to everybody I know. Doing some promo. Maybe we'll throw it into NJCAA. Why not?
Yeah, let's do it.
Everybody. Oh, and our jersey concepts just got designed. We have brand new jerseys for those of y'all that know we're going to be ordering. So, is this Remy behind me?
Yep. Yeah.
Remy is joining us. Remy is going to be running our Smash tournament.
Yeah, you can
bend down, kind of like see wherever you're. Yes, you got to bend that kind of go. There you go. There's Remy. So, Remy is going to be new to our team in the spring. Remy's going to be doing Super Smash Bros. Mm-hmm. So, and Remy is going to be running our Smash Bros. Tournament. So, it's going to be exciting from as soon as we hear from Dr. Henshaw and do like a little bit of a start. So, yeah, it's going to be awesome.
Okay, I'll back out. Smiles and jump in. Jump in again.
Oh. And we need to apparently move our chat box over a little bit. So yeah. Oh yeah, let's go Hawks. Yeah, absolutely. Hawks by 90, as we always say. So, but we're going to get set and ready to rock and roll. I'm going to get the screen up for MLB The Show. Ready to rock and roll. So we're going to have Dr. Henshaw. We're going to have Dr. Henshaw pick out the character suit, the players that he wants to play as. We've got a little bit of a story about Dr. Henshaw as well that you're going to want to hear on stream. We'll move back to the Just Chatting screen. Yeah, thank you all so much for joining us. This is going to be really, hopefully, monumental and... it'll be interesting. It'll be very, very interesting. Tweeting this out to about everybody that I know. Make sure that we're ready to rock and roll. And oh yeah, Parzival with the. Good morning to Remy and Brad and Coach. I'm on my way. Also, yeah, so we've got Foodie is Nick. I was just telling you about that does plays in the jazz ensemble. Oh, Parzival subscribe. So we've got our first sub of the day. That's awesome from a player. So anybody else wants to hop in and just help us out, support us. Also, shout out to Respawn. Respawn products, we've got their chairs here, as you see. I'm trying to lean back. Respawn products, we've got their chairs and desks. They're a local company here, so we appreciate them. We actually won a contest a few years ago for their chairs and their chairs and their desk and stuff. So we're really excited. So, but we'll get started, ready to rock and roll here. I'm sending out everything I can, all the links and whatnot. I think our headphones just died.
Got the headphones out. I'll put them back in last time.
Yeah, we'll let them charge them a little bit. We don't really need them, so for this first opening part. If you're in chat, say hello. Let us know how you are. We would love. We've got 5 viewers right now. Early started. Oh yeah. So I can look at this. Oh Lord, my head is so big that I can't even fit it on there. Santa coach. We'll try to do some. Let's see. I was gonna try to do some like festive Christmas music, but I didn't bring it over here. Yeah, so all my players are gathered. Y'all can like hang out behind me, or like y'all can feel free to pop on in. Christian, you can pop in. Christian's another one of our new players for the. You can get a chair, hop on over. Christian's gonna be one of our new players for the spring. He is a North Lincoln product. We've almost accumulated the entire populations of Catawba and Lincoln County. So if you're in East Lincoln High School or if you're at Newton Conover High School, we would love to have you join our roster so that we can completely knock that entire list off. So Christian's from North Lincoln. We had Bradley went to West Lincoln and Donovan went to Lincolnton. So we have North Lincoln. So all we're missing is East Lincoln. Tell them about you. Since you're new to our program, our team.
My name's Christian Brown, and my gamer tag's actually Brownie Boy, and that comes from a nickname I had growing up. A lot of my friends called me Brownie because my last name is Brown, so stuck with that. The games I'm going to be playing for the team this coming semester is Rocket League and Call of Duty. Not the greatest at Rocket League, I'll say, but I'll try.
First off, thank you to Najdeem Priotelli for the follow. We got that in there. We'll kind of keep track, too, of the how the donations and stuff are coming in today. We don't have a way to do an alert through their website, but once we get donations, we'll let people know. You know, thank them and support them for the support that they're giving us. So, sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off, Christian. I just saw that kind of pop up. And there's alerts that pop up, too, when you sub, when you donate, when you follow, everything. So
I think it's still on Brandon's lap.
No. Oh, yeah.
That's what it was last night.
Yeah, some of them are built into the games that we play, like Reyna that's on Valorant. So, like, if you follow, it'll do her laugh or whatever. So, but yeah, awesome. Well, we're probably here like 5 minutes away from Dr. Henshaw coming in.
Yeah.
What do you think about our president coming to play video games? How's that?
It's pretty cool. I mean, the fact that you're able to get the president to come of the school to come play video games like that.
Oh yeah, I'm about to say how many presidents would show up to a live stream for esports and like fundraising and stuff.
Play.
Oh yeah, definitely. So yeah, we're still just chatting now. We'll swap over to MLB The Show in just a second. Once Dr. Henshaw comes in here, we'll probably talk to him for just a little bit and then let him do that. Our Smash tournament might start a little bit late, but. You know, we're just kind of having fun. We've literally got the 2 a.m. hour and the 7 a.m. hour to catch up and support our. Hopefully, we have some Australian Red Hawk fans out there. That would be really cool. Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. So I don't know. But we'll see. See what happens. Again, !! Donate, please. If you can't donate, if you don't have any money, I understand. It's Christmas time. It's a lot of people that are tight on money, or they've spent, you know, a lot of money on Christmas gifts or whatnot. You know, be sure to just share that link. That helps us a ton. So what we would love for you just to pass the word. If you know somebody that's big into gaming and whatnot, just be sure to share that. We would love to impact a lot more lives here at Catawba Valley. We're already doing it. You know, our students are just done tremendously this fall. You'll hear from some of them later. We actually have some testimonial videos from some of our players who kind of wanted to talk about their experience here. So that way you're going to hear from them and kind of understand what their, you know, what their experience has been like here. Some have improved grade-wise, some have improved leadership-wise. Some have just found a second family here. So it's more than gaming what we're trying to do here. We're trying to teach life lessons. We're trying to teach, obviously, academics, discipline, just being accountable, being good students, being good people. And we're building a really special community here of people at Catawba Valley who are, you know, I'm just so incredibly proud to coach this group. And that's why I'm dedicating my time today and tomorrow to being able to do a 24-hour stream. Appreciate everybody who is hopping in. If you're lurking, make sure you hit that follow button. That's the bare minimum you could do for us and help us. We'd love to get up to like 500 followers. So yeah. Yeah, apologize for being quiet a little bit. I'm trying to.
Sorry, yeah, I'm sharing it out too.
Yeah, I'm trying to share it with people that I know. But yeah. But yeah, we'll hopefully here in the next couple minutes be joined by our esteemed president, Dr. Garrett Henshaw. It'll be really, really awesome. We are awaiting his arrival. A busy, busy man. He is always into something. And we just appreciate him going to join us for a few minutes here on stream.
I know, it's crazy that we actually got him. I can't believe it. Like, he's usually like super busy. I never see him like at all.
Well, thankfully, for those of y'all don't know, the semester just ended. It just ended here Tuesday. So we're just kind of trying to get things wrapped up and ready for the 2021 calendar year. So, or 2022 calendar year, it closing out the 2021 calendar year. So, yeah, we'll get set and ready to go here and rocking and rolling. As again, we'll kind of show you the schedule again so y'all know. If there's a game that you like, there are options. If there's something you want us to play, you know what? If you donate $100, we'll let you pick the game. We'll shift some things and we'll let you pick the game.
We will stop what we're doing and let you choose what we do next.
Yeah, if you subscribe, if you get us, what do you think? What's a fair price for subscriptions? I would say donation. If you donate $100, we'll let you pick the game instantly. We'll just stop what we're doing. We'll let you pick the game.
Just keep it PG.
Yeah, yeah. We can't play no GTA. No, you know. Obviously, we're at college, so we got to watch. But if there's something that's like, hey, I want to play, I don't know, League of Legends. Yeah. If you want us to keep going, if you say, hey, I love Crab Game, you know, let's keep going. We'll push stuff. We'll keep going. We'll push Phasmophobia to 1 o'clock. We'll push Beat Saber back an hour. So if you like what we're doing, yeah, just.
Hey, maybe they like Fortnite Squad so much they just wipe out the entire thing and just have Fortnite Squad.
Yeah, there you go. Maybe like, yeah. So
that's the total of like $2,000.
Yeah, no, definitely. And we'll keep track of these donations. So if you donate, if you say, hey, I donated like $100 and I want y'all to play this, like, we will do it. We will, as long as it is a game that is family friendly and is not, you know, all over the place. So yeah, it's gonna be awesome. So we're excited. We're excited to see what we can do here today. But you see all the games we're gonna be playing. We're gonna have Dr. Henshaw here in just a second for MLB The Show. We got a Smash Brothers tournament going on that's going to kick it off. Mario Kart from 3 to 4. Fortnite Squads 4 to 6. Call of Duty Zombies from 6 to 7. Valorant from 7 to 9. Crab Game, which is like the cartoon version of Squid Games. If you've watched it on Netflix, that's going to be from 9 to 10. 10 to 11 is Beat Saber, which is an Oculus game. So we're going to put that on our head and face and play. I don't even know what it is, but we're going to play it. And we're going to be entertaining. And then 11 to midnight, some Apex probably. Midnight to 2 a.m., some Phasmophobia. And then 2 to 8, we're going to be doing all sorts of craziness. We'll just kind of see how it goes. Maybe some community games among us, get some people in. Also, from 8 to 9, we're going to be doing pancakes with the man cake. So wake up, have some breakfast with our very own man cake, a.k.a. Parzival, a.k.a. Bradley. He is the man cake, the myth, the legend, as we call him. And then, obviously, we'll probably play some Fortnite after that. I don't know, but like I said, if y'all have games y'all want to play and y'all donate enough money or subscriptions, we'll swap over. We'll do it in a heartbeat.
You guys want me to keep cooking, just donate and I'll keep cooking.
Yeah, we'll just
come up and get your own food.
If you want Bradley to, like, cook for, like, two or three hours, you know what? We'll just keep going. I'll run over to Walmart and we'll get some food and we'll just keep cooking randomness. I don't know what it'll be. It may be bacon. It may be hamburgers. It may be eggs. It'll have to be something very simple because we're very limited on what
we
can do.
All we have is a griddle.
We can't bake like lasagna or something crazy.
We don't have an industrial oven like we should.
Although this used to be a cafeteria that we're gaming in. So, and then we'll have closing comments at 11:45. So yeah, we're just getting set ready to rock and roll. Our main man Donovan is. Donovan and Devontae have arrived to the gaming arena. So they can't see y'all as it's tilted so weird. And I'd move it, but so Donovan, aka he's famous for being actually both of these guys in the newspaper in like the last 2 weeks. You see Devontae is our first ever playoff qualifier.
I got a story to tell y'all.
And then there's Donovan. Donovan was in the paper. He's awesome. You're going to hear Donovan's testimony here in a little bit later, his testimony video that we put together. So they're getting ready to, I believe, they're going to be playing some NBA 2K or something over here. So some 2K22. Yeah, I got that for y'all. That and there's a copy of Madden over there.
I have a story behind that.
Of what?
I went to Oyster Shuckin' something. The seafood place right beside McDonald's over here.
Uh-huh.
I went in there and it was like, who's that kid in the newspaper?
No kid.
Yeah, like,
wow, so the oyster folks know Devontae. This is awesome.
Yeah.
Yes. We are famous. The kid from the newspaper. I love it. So people are starting to see, recognize our group.
Hey, tell them how
you ran. I did run away.
He ran away. You ain't supposed to run away. You're supposed to be proud. I mean, if I was in a newspaper and like it was like, oh, you're that guy, like I'd be, oh, that's cool. So that's what Donovan did. Donovan's like, yeah, I'm in the paper. Yeah. Oh, actually, you pull it up here. Look at this. Look at this man.
I went to the second oyster place.
24-hour stream, and then not only that, he's on the bottom page of the sports section.
So, you know that dude you scrimmaged?
Yeah.
He played the dude from my group in 2K for the championship.
Yeah, the guy that he.
So how did he close to being, dude? How did he lose?
He lost in the. Was it the round of 4 or round of 8? No, he beat the guy that beat
me.
You, and then he lost in the next. No. Yeah, he lost in the next round. So he was like third round. So, yeah, we had a lot of craziness like with NJCAA. So Donovan was in a group with the eventual champion for NBA 2K, and then our Valorant team was in a group with the eventual champion for Valorant, Madison College. Shout out to Madison, Menace, and C-Dog and those guys. They're really, really awesome. Very, very good sportsmen and very, very good Valorant players. So congrats to them. They had a really great season run. And a really great final against Nova in the NJCAA. So while we're still waiting for Dr. Henshaw, I'm going to give you a little bit of kind of background on us. So our esports program was started in the summer of 2019. During that fall, they asked me to be the head coach. Now, for me, it's been a blessing because I went to a college to teach and coach. I got told by many people at my college, and I won't say said college's name, but I got told, and I'm not about being blasphemous or being angry about things, but I got told by people at my college that you know, you can't do this and you can't do that, and really just told that what I couldn't do. And, you know, I think for a long time I held it in as kind of a thing that just really made me bitter. And, you know, I wanted to teach and coach basketball, and it didn't end up working out. So I get into communications. I've been in PR, communications, and writing for newspapers for a decade of my life. And now I'm here at CBCC. I promote all of our college's activities that we have going on. We have so much wonderful things here at Catawba Valley Community College. I don't just say that because I can say that and I work here. I say that because I truly believe that, and I've seen it firsthand. There are some amazing people. There's some amazing programs. There's an amazing community here, and I'm doing as best I can to get that story out there. But for the big thing, too, you know, in summer 2019, I got asked to thank you, Terry Livingston. Yeah, Terry. Terry does our fundraising. She's awesome. Be sure to reach out to her if you need help or if you want to help sponsor our program. So, but yeah, I got summer 2019, I got asked to coach this. It was a blessing for me because I got to do something that I went to college to do. Now, flash forward, we have been through so much, and I would love to show them the picture here. See if I can pull it up. I need to pull it up on stream.
We need to have like a old photograph of it.
Yeah, just keep it in the, I'm just gonna keep this thing. But we started in the summer or the fall of 2019. I started recruiting. So, and it's from there. It's just been a journey. It's been amazing. But we're joined now on stream. We're gonna get ready to get joined and in here by a very famous face here on campus, by our president, Dr. Garrett Henshaw. We were just talking about, the kids were saying, what college president comes on a Twitch stream and hops in and like supports the programs? But I've told them, I said, Dr. Henshaw is far different from any college president that you will see out there. So, thanks for joining us.
Yeah, Cody, thank you so much for inviting me. I mean, this is what it's all about, are the students. And anytime that we're doing something that engages individuals, and I'm going to do it. You know, it is probably different than a lot of what people would think a college president does, but I'm not just a college president. I'm here to serve these students. And if we can find value and create value, then that's what we're going to commit to.
Absolutely. Well, I was just telling them about Terry's in here. Our prez pegs the cool meter. That's awesome. Yeah, I was just telling everybody about just what an amazing place this campus is, and how many amazing people, students, programs. I'm blessed just to be a part of it. You know, people see it on face value and say, oh, he works at college, he's going to promote it. But I mean, when you truly believe in something, I think that echoes and that shines through a lot of people and programs on this campus, I believe.
Well, when I think about, you know, my education career and just having somebody that believes in every individual, that every individual has opportunity and value, that's what drives me. It's what makes this so important to me, because I almost didn't get through education. You know, it just, the engagement wasn't there. And if I can provide some inspiration or some hope for somebody, that's what I'm all about.
Absolutely. Well,
but I'm no good at video games.
Well, I got a little surprise for you. So I reached out to some people at Appalachian State. So for those of y'all that don't know, this is Dr. Garrett Henshaw at Appalachian State. He was a baseball player from 87 to 90 and a really good one at that. But just to let you know how good he was, so left-handed, number 30, played outfield, four-year letterman, has 26 career home runs at Appalachian, which is still in the top 10, which is amazing. And then an all-region and an all-first-team all-Southern Conference in 89. And I was reading a little bit of the bio, and you posted it on Twitter, I read it, but led the Mountaineers in, and I misspelled Mountaineers, I just realized that, but Mountaineers in 9 offensive stats in 1989.
Well, go Nears. That was a great time, but I tell you, that was a long time ago, Cody, and just, you know, that experience and the things that I learned about being a team player and about having the competitive edge and really seeing what it means to lead. That was the genesis of everything that I'm about, and I thank Appalachia State University for that opportunity.
Definitely. Well, and we just thank you. I know you've built an amazing, not just a campus. I know for me on the athletic end, just so many amazing opportunities. We just added a bass fishing program for those y'all don't know. That's already changing lives. This right here is to be able to say that you have 20 students in an esports program and playing video games, and you'll hear from some of them. We've done testimonial videos. You'll hear from some of them throughout the day as to kind of how this has impacted them, but it's changing grades, it's changing mindsets, it's getting kids to even think about just, you know, hey, what career field can I get into? I've got one student here who's gonna share his story about getting into cameras and video and things like that. So it's really, really cool that there's avenues like this, not just your traditional sports, although those are fantastic as well, but this non-traditional avenue too that's growing too as well.
Yeah, no doubt. We're always looking for new opportunities. If we're doing the same things we did 5 years ago, we're going to become obsolete and non-relevant. And it's all about the student experience here in Red Hawk Nation, and that's what we've created. We've invested in it. We've committed to it. And we look forward to what the future holds. We've got cross country coming on, too.
I about to say, we just had Sean Fountain on WHKY Radio doing an interview this morning to promote cross country. So if you're fast and you want to run and you want to do some stuff, and get a quality education and compete, you're going to have a chance to do so and get an quality affordable education. That's the most important part. So, yeah, awesome. So I thought we would flash back to the graphics we showed about baseball, and I kept thinking, what's a game that Dr. Henshaw could play? We were thinking, like, we can't play Valorant's crazy with all, you got to know all these abilities and things. So let's simplify. So let's just do MLB the Show.
Oh, my.
So that's what we're going to do is MLB the Show. We thought we'd do just like a home run derby. So, thank you, Almighty Jackson. We got people hopping in the stream for the first time. It's awesome. We've got over 10 people in chat now. But we thought we'd have you do like MLB the Show home run derby, and it's real easy because all you got to do is just flick the bat and try to hit home runs.
Okay.
And same thing with baseball. So you get to pick who you want to play as. I don't know if you've got a favorite team or a favorite.
I want to be Big Pappy.
Big Pappy. Let's see. Oh, we got him on here, I believe. Yeah, David Ortiz.
That's it.
There we go. He's on the
left-handed.
The Beasts. So. Do one of y'all want to play against Dr. Henshaw and be on the other side of the home run derby bracket? No pressure. No pressure.
Hey, don't worry. I used to swing and miss a lot in college, too.
Anybody want to do it? He hasn't either, so you're on even playing field. I need somebody volunteer. Bradley, you want to do it? Oh, Bradley's doing it.
Bring it, Bradley.
Stepping up to the plate. So, Bradley, who do you want to play as? It's going to be one-on-one. I knew you was going to do it. I was waiting.
Cody doesn't know he embraced
Me and Bradley talk a lot about Atlanta Braves, so I knew you were going there. Freddie Freeman. Not as much power as Big Poppy, though. So, all right, so who wants to go first? So basically what you're going to do is you're just going to...
Flip that up.
Yeah, flip that up every time a ball comes.
Yep.
But you're going to try to get as much... All right, what stadium y'all want to play at?
We got to play at Fenway.
He's going to stack the deck. He's going to be left-handed bat at Fenway. And you got two left-handed.
Two left.
There we go, Fenway Park. Playtime standard. So I believe you get a timeout on. Well, or we can turn the timeout. Let's just turn the timeout on. So you're going to get, 2-3 minutes? What do you think?
Yeah, 3 minutes.
Let's do 3 minutes. Standard. So you're going to player one, and then Bradley, you're going to be player two. So you're going to set it up. So you're going to play. Basically, you're just going to flip with this, just that.
Yep.
That's all you're gonna have to worry about, I believe, if I've set it up right. If not, we'll reset it. Good
If a contestant hits two home runs,
here we go.
Poppy versus Freeman.
An additional 30 seconds of bonus time. The player who hits the most home runs will be a crowned champion.
Capture call. People will be able to hear it, and they'll be able to hear us. Final round. Look at this. They don't even have a picture. They got to make the CGI. Like, he's not. He's alive. Like, I see him on TV for this. There we go. So I have five. Now so we're getting. Oh no! So Bradley's
home run derby. Hitting first in this championship round.
Y'all need to sit over there.
Freddie Freeman.
Let's get in there, bro. There we go.
I can get my choke up for my
little
John Smoltz. I appreciate everybody in here. Thanks for.
I think we both have to use it, though.
Hopefully, I have to take it for this,
though. You told me to plug that in.
And here we go.
Trying to flick it. Scary
filming. There you go. There you go.
There's a
little bit foul,
so it's a.
Just foul. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Yes, we do. Oh, yes.
Oh, good.
That one may have a
chance. There's no outs, so you did. Oh, there it is. There it is.
Yep.
Top shelf.
There's another one. Now he's in the groove.
2 minutes remaining.
Oh, yes. Warning track power.
Home run.
I get a lot of those too. That's when your heart breaks when you get one in the sweet spot. It's about 10 foot foul.
Yep. Oh, right over.
Nick,
that is Gamertag Foodie. You'll hear from him too. We have a video testimony.
Out
of here.
Fun fact, I have actually signed the test control at Fenway, which you got to do if you go to Boston.
I've never been able to go there because I've always been.
My wife, bless her heart, she actually saved up 1 year and got us Red Sox Yankees tickets. Talk about rivalries and fun. And that's awesome. I'm classic. I'd rather go to an old Walmart.
There's another one.
Oh, yeah.
We got 30 seconds left.
There you go. That's going to turn back.
So we got 10 seconds. This may be the. Probably got one more. Oh, it's dead center.
I don't think he's gonna make it.
But you got 30 seconds bonus time because I guess you hit. I think it's if you hit a home run so long, like 400 and some feet. Oh, dead center.
He takes out the deepest part of the yard.
See, what we should have done is put two righties in here and played it Fenway. See who could get one over the monster.
That's too hard. We had a short drive to a point that last night.
I love listening to the commentary for the post show.
Let's see what he can do.
So it's like the same thing. Now, we were talking earlier. Have you ever played any video games?
I've played a few. The old style. I'm over too. I'm playing the big Bobby Clump.
That's the rough thing about this game, is it's like, you gotta almost hit the perfect hell and sleep.
Two minutes remaining.
He picks the place of the monster that's gone off of. Oh yeah, so you get a bonus if you hit. If you hit 2 440-foot opponents, that's like. There we go. Yeah.
Boom. Out of here.
Here we go. Here we go. He's feeling it. Yeah. Yeah. It's like watching the real home run derby. Oh, 11.
Into the seats at center.
Oh. Go up. Monster. Monster. Yeah.
It's out of here. That one.
Oh, another one. Another one. This one's big, I think. I think this is over 40. Oh, right at it. Bradley, I think your extra time might come into play here. Boom, 423. Get a little nervous. Oh, that's another one. Oh, that one's definitely. Oh. Go. Oh.
30 seconds left.
Oh, no. Yep, there's another one. 7. Bradley, your extra time's going.
Yeah, Mike's not really helping. Yeah.
He's going at one more. I'm doing it. It's going to be 9-8. Oh, did it go? Oh.
He ends the round with
9-8. That is not quite enough.
Yeah. He's been eliminated.
Oh, good job, brother. Good job, brother.
Awesome.
That was cool.
Ladies and gentlemen.
This is
Again. Ready. Freeman.
Very rarely do you see the National League win things with All-Star games.
I like Freddy, though. That's a good one.
I'm hoping. Cheap plug, but hoping he stays in Atlanta Brave. I know he's a free agent. But awesome. Well,
thanks for letting me come down and get beat. I always appreciate that opportunity.
I will never live this down as long as I'm here at the college.
But the best thing about it, I got beat by a Red Hawk. So I'm not feeling too bad about that today.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Thank you so much for being a part of this. I think this is
This is going to be awesome. He's actually going to be doing a cooking stream. We're going to do it in real life cooking. Bradley's going to be a part of Hospitality Academy, so he's actually going to be and he plays guitar. He actually, I brag on him, he took 20 credit hours. He got an A in every class, so that tells you kind of the students that we're putting out, and very talented, and he's already thinking about starting a business, and so he's...
Hey, Red Hawk Nation's got something for everybody. You know, we do focus on each person as an individual and try to find your passion and help you to definitely be successful going forward. So every person that walks on this campus, we value. And Bradley, thank you for choosing Red Hawk Nation to continue your education.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, awesome. Well, we appreciate Dr. Henshaw hopping on again. Help support our programs. You're going to see links in the chat to be able to donate, help donate. If you donate $100, we've already said, we're going to immediately switch games to whatever you want to play. Now, it has to be something PG and something not. We're not going to play GTA. We're not going to play anything that's inappropriate. But you donate $100 or more, we're going to immediately switch games and hop on to something else. We're just about supporting it today and helping all these students and spotlighting the amazing things that they do. And you're going to hear more from them. They're more than gamers. They're students that are learning. They're figuring themselves out. They're understanding the abilities they have. They're finding things that they enjoy that they're going to get into career field. So it's really, really awesome. But it's really, really cool when your president comes on and is a part of the live stream on twitch.tv/CVCCRedHawks.
So. And gets drilled. That's the bad part. I'm gonna have to deal with that from now on.
But hey,
I'm coming back down for a rematch, brother.
Hey, maybe that'll be in the future. We'll have a rematch of the century and MLB the show. But again, thank you, Dr. Henshaw. We appreciate so much. I know me personally, I shared my testimony earlier about wanting to coach. Yeah. I've been able to live that dream now. These kids are, I think a lot of them are living the dream and being able to grow personally, professionally, career-wise. Some of them I've even been contacted by four-year schools about recruiting and going on the next level. Yeah. So it's really, really cool, and it's a blessing. And we're just so thankful, not only for what you do for us, but for our campus.
It's never about me, Cody. It's always about we, and having people like you as a part of our team makes all the difference in the world, helps us be successful. When I first met you, I knew you were passionate about kids and students in general, and just wanted to be the best that you can be, and we're going to help you get there too.
All right. Well, and already doing
as long
that.
As you'll dance on the Jumbotron at Atlanta Braves game one more time.
Yeah, and don't and you know what? If somebody donates $50, we'll put it on the stream of me doing it. I will
donate that. That is donated right now.
Man, maybe I should have went more than $50. This is such a great place. This team is so wonderful, but this campus is so wonderful. If you want a quality, affordable education, come to CVCC, and I guarantee you, you won't. I don't say this as a model of, hey, I work here. I say this from a genuine point of view because I've worked with so many wonderful people here. You're going to get an amazing quality. I mean, we literally just had a young lady from Los Angeles move here to come to the Hospitality Academy because she wanted a life-changing experience. That's incredible. But you're going to get that here.
And there's 5,000 stories just like that.
Yeah,
sitting right here,
and I try to tell as many of them as I can. It gets hard sometimes, but it starts at the top with this guy. Again, thank you, Dr. Henshaw. We're so, so thankful, and thank you for letting us do this because some of us are literally going to sleep overnight here at the arena so we can create the 24 hours. And I think we're the first junior college to ever do it. And I know how much you love First, so we're the first one to do it.
Yep.
And we're talking about maybe even doing it in the spring, maybe doing a charity event or something. So we'll. We'll hopefully keep it going. But thank you. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Coach. Yeah. Thank you, Bradley.
And Bradley.
Thank
you.
Good job.
Thank you. We have the handshake after the result.
Except
we're gonna have to have the rematch. That's gonna be coming up.
Point, yeah.
So awesome. So we'll switch over our next portion of the stream. We've got coming on is Super Smash Bros. We're going to get Remy to set that up really, really quickly here. Just give us 1 second. We'll get everything set up. And we'll get ready to rock and roll for our second segment here of the 24-hour CVCC Red Hawk Esports stream. Be right back in just a second.